Welcome to Miracles Today broadcast. Listen, I'm telling you, Jesus has planned some mighty for America. And he came to me, he sent an angel to me in a dream in 2010, 2009, and 2008, preparing me and telling me to tell the body of Christ that a new move of God is up on the horizon in America, and it started in 2010. This is 2011. I am excited about the beginning of something major coming to our country. And as you know, this week we've been interviewing people who the Lord has appeared to and how he has changed their lives radically. I am telling you, this is not mysticism. It is not a fantasy. Jesus is real. He is alive and he has risen from the dead. And I want you to know he wants face-to-face contact. He wants an intimacy with you that goes beyond just prayer time, goes beyond just you feeling his presence, goes beyond just you hearing his voice. He wants you to have direct contact with him, and you can. It is possible today, and this is up on the earth again. Listen, I have some wonderful friends and a family that I love very dearly, that is very dear to me, and I am just so excited that they are my guests today. And it is the Smith family, Pastor Steve and Karen Smith. I'm so happy to have y'all today.
Thank you for having us here. It's wonderful. It's a great honor.
What do y'all think about what God has been doing here? I mean, with hearing all the testimonies of the Lord appearing to so many people, of course, he's appeared to you all, and we want to hear your testimony in just a moment. But what do you feel about all of this tremendous phenomena that's happening here?
Well, it's changing our lives. It's changed our lives. Not only has he appeared to us, but to our daughters, our son-in-law, our daughter-in-law. Yes. Just changing our lives.
Yeah, he appeared to your daughter-in-law all the way in Taiwan. Isn't that right?
Yes.
In a dream.
In a dream.
It's just amazing.
Yes.
Go on.
Yeah, he came to her. It was a very hard time in their life, and came to her in a dream with the arms stretched out, and she just immediately felt such peace. And as she came to him, they had a hug, they had an embrace.
Wow, yeah. She got to hug the Lord Jesus. Yeah. Wow, that is amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, that's tremendous. I am trying in this generation to build honor for the level of what this is, because I don't think people get it. When they hear it, they just think, well, Jesus just came in a dream, or I just had a vision. They wake up, they don't think it's real. This is more real than the very air you're breathing right now. This is more real than anything in this world that you could ever imagine. And so I guess I'm trying to show them that they would think it a great honor for the President of the United States to come to their home and meet with them face to face. This is someone greater than the United States, greater than a king.
Yes.
He's emperor over two whole worlds and many more that we don't even know about. He is the potentate of the universe, and he's chosen to come.
About our daughter-in-law, she lives in Taiwan with our son, and she's very lonely, very sad, being away from her family. And that's when you came to her, she was saying how she just felt so loved. But you had said to us at church that God was going to visit all of our children, that every one of our children would have a visitation from the Lord. And right after that, our daughter Christine had a visitation, Jennifer had a visitation, then our daughter-in-law had a visitation, and I'm waiting for my sons now.
Wow.
You know, I'm not sure. I need to check with my sons and see if it's happened already. I haven't
right.
checked on them. And of course, he's visited Steve and I, and he's changed our life. It's just wonderful what God's doing.
Karen, Jesus appeared to you. It was just such a tremendous and momentous time when he came to you, because it was such a drastic change in your life. Why don't you tell us about when Jesus first came to you?
It was huge. I was, I've been in church my entire life, and I was just kind of doing church.
Yes.
And you came and you started telling us about how Jesus could come to you. Also, you said you told a lot of things, how the Lord would come to us, or we could go to heaven. And it was just, I was just like, Wow. And
didn't
I
know all these things
before
today.
No,
and that Christians were supposed to be experiencing these things.
No, we're not. Not till we get to heaven. That's how I was brought up. I was Pentecostal.
Yeah,
so,
right.
So I was just like, I can't believe this can happen. And I remember saying to the Lord, you know, Lord, I want this. I want what Apostle Taylor has. I want you to come to me.
Yes.
And so I was at home one day. Oh, and I had read your one book. And I don't like reading. I'm just being honest. I'm not one to sit and just with a book all the time. And I started reading your book, and I couldn't put it down. And you can ask Steve and the kids, that's not me at all. So I just kept reading the book, and I locked in the room, and I was like, I want this. I really want this, you know. Because I was a Thomas, and the kids tease me when I say that. But I really was a Thomas. I wanted proof. I needed to see this. And I think that's something everyone I've listened to has in common, the doubting.
Yes.
Doubting it.
Because, and the reason why, do y'all feel like the reason why there's such doubt is because this type of, I think, thing has been missing for thousands of years. It's not normal Christianity.
Oh, no.
I don't know how to explain it, but I just feel like it's a new, it ain't new to God, but it's new to this generation. It's new to this, I mean, this whole, I think the last thousand, two, so many years, hundreds of years, that people are not aware of this type of thing.
It's refreshing.
Oh, wow.
It's like a when you drink a cold glass of water on a hot day, like,
wow.
You know, just like, you know, it's so refreshing to know that He loves us enough that He would come to us. And so when I came to your services and you were talking about it and you said that the Lord was going to appear to us, I went home and I wanted that. And I was doubtful, I'm being honest. I was like, you know, okay, if this is real, come on, I want this to happen to me. And then I really started praying. I went from that to like, all right, Lord, I really want this. And I was worshiping the Lord before I went to work one day, and I had Kim Clement's song on, Thomas, about Thomas, of all songs. And he was singing, Thomas, Touch My Hands. And the Lord appeared to me.
Wow.
Sorry, I don't mean to cry. And he was in the most beautiful white robe I've ever seen. I've never seen a white that white in my life. You know, I even told you have a very beautiful white jacket.
Yes.
It was whiter than that. It was just beautiful. And he had his hands outstretched like that. And Apostle, I changed instantly. My life was changed instantly. I was bitter. I was just tired of just an ugly person. And I couldn't wait to get to work and tell everybody. And so I was driving to work. Oh, and that's the other thing, the Lord gave me a boldness that I did not have.
Wow.
I did not have that. And so I had lost it.
I see that when you get on the stage. And I love that when you're telling that testimony.
Well,
but you wasn't like that.
No.
Wow.
No.
Was I? Wasn't like that.
No, there has been a change.
Wow.
Yeah, I wasn't bold like that. But I went,
both of us.
I went to work and I told my coworkers about it. And I would have never done that in the past. I would have never, I was very, you know, I didn't talk a lot. They knew I was a Christian, but that's about as far as it went. You know, I really didn't share. And so I started sharing it with them. And I just had a boldness like I've never had before. And I remember my coworker, she's like, I want that. And I've since been able to share with other coworkers. God's given me a boldness where I've been able to share about the book. Because people want something. They need something more than what we're giving them.
Yeah.
They want a relationship. I tell them that now. I go, I had religion for... I'm going to be 29. I'm going to be 48. And I've had religion. And now I'm learning through your ministry about relationship. And that's what people want. And so it was just beautiful. Then I started reading the Bible. And it was funny because it's a story I've known since I was a child. And I taught children's church about Daniel,
yes.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. You know, all these stories I started reading. And they started jumping out. Just jumping off the page, it was real now that Jesus really walked in the furnace.
Yes.
Because I know He walks in the furnace.
Yes.
I saw Him. He walked. He was in my room.
Wow.
So it just became, the Word became real. It just became real. And under your teaching, same thing. Things that I've never known. And my mind goes like this a lot. Sometimes, you know, if I wander. But when you preach and you start sharing the Word, I watch the people here too. I mean, we're on the edge of our seats because it's just you're teaching us and showing us in the Word the truth how we can have this. It's real.
I just see Jesus. I tell you, He's alive. I've just seen Jesus.